Hi children, welcome back. In this video we will discuss about the crop production, how we are going to grow the crops and what are the steps of the crop production. I hope you all are enjoying all the videos and you have done all the homeworks which is given in the previous videos. It would be better for you only if you do the homeworks regularly, okay. So this is a topic, very important topic, that we know that we are going to live, we all are going to survive only with the help of the plants. If there is no plant, the animals and the human beings are not at all going to survive their life. For example, in a crop production means how we are going to produce the crops. For example, if I want to eat a chapati, okay, then how the chapati has come? You don't say that the chapati has come from the kitchen, but inside the kitchen how it has come, there are so many steps behind this. That is only from the science will come to know that how, which are the steps and how it has come. That is how we are discussing about the production of the crops or crop production in this video. For example, if I want to eat a chapati, I should have the flour. Flour means, you know, that flour which your mother will use to prepare the chapati. First she will make it wet and she will make a rolls of it, and again using a rolling pan she will prepare a chapati and frying of that one, then you will eat that one. Before getting a flour, what is the procedure? We need a wheat. Okay, we need wheat, and those wheat should be taken to the grinding mill. There we will get the flour of the wheat or the jowar, that may be roti or that may be chapati. Then before this, from where the jowar and the wheat has come? Of course, from the grocery shop. To the grocery shop, from where it has come? To the grocery shop, it has come from the farmer. Then the farmer is going to grow these all in his field. Okay. Then how he is going to grow these all in his field? First, to grow any crop, the farmer is going to prepare the soil. The first step we call as a preparing of the soil. Then what he will do in preparation of the soil? So I think you might have seen, even you might be having the lands also in which your father, grandfather, uncles are working. You might have seen, preparing of the soil means making the soil even and loosening the soil and cleaning the soil, that if some other weeds are there, they will, with the help of a weeding, they will prepare the soil or clean the soil. So if the soil is very clean and loosened and even, it would be helpful for the plants to grow very easily and they can give a good crop. For the production of the crop, then the first step is known as the preparing the field. That is, in the preparing we are cleaning the field and we are making the even of the soil and we are loosening the soil. These are what the simple steps of preparing of the soil. Then in a crop production, which is the first step? Preparing of the soil is the first step. If once the preparing of the soil is done, what they will do? Then the second step is sowing of the seeds. We already know that the whatever the plants, if we want to grow, the 80% of the reproduction will take place with the help of the seeds. For example, this is what the fruit of the plant I have here, and inside we get a seed. If this seed once again is sown inside the soil, we are going, there is a possibility of getting another one same plant after the sowing of the seed. Of course, other than the seed, we have a reproduction from the plant, from the different parts of the plants too. That may be the leaf of the plant, or that may be the other stem part of the plant, and that may be the root part of the plant. But most oftenly used method is from seed. If we are going to sowing the seeds inside the soil, we will get, after some days we will get another one plant, and which is of the same type of the previous plant. Okay, then the next step is sowing of the seed. So in the sowing, we know that how they are going to sow. Sowing is done in the farmers are going to do the sowing. So they will use the seed drills to sow the seeds in the field. Those seed drills will be having a like a holes in their bottom part. If you put the seeds in head part or in the upper side or the top of the that instrument, those all seeds will come and fall down equally. As the tractor will go front, the seeds are going to be fall in a straight line in the field. If the once the seeds have touched or buried inside the soil, after some time they will grow into a new plant if once they get the water and the some warmth. If they once they get the water and the some warmth, then our first step is preparing of the field, and second step is sowing of the seeds, and then third step is irrigation. Okay, then preparing of the soil is over, sowing is over, and the this one putting the seeds, that is sowing of the seeds, is over. If once we put the seeds inside the soil, then there must be a supply of water, sufficient water, so then only the plants are going to grow easily. Then the third step is what? Third step is what? The irrigation. For the irrigation, again we are following a different types of the methods or different methods. One is just we will make a pipeline for the field, and we will make some points, particular points. From there we will get the water, and there will be a way or passage to the field from where the water may go, like this in a rectangle manner or a square manner. Again like this water is going, and the seeds are going to get the water. This is what the most commonly used system of irrigation. Then other than this, in ancient days there were only one method, by using the labors or by using the animals. They used to take the water from the well or the pond. Again they are going to pour the water, and next they will make the path for water to flow, and the water is going to flow in each and every line of the sown seed. But nowadays in advanced technology, we have two famous different types of our system of the irrigation. One is known as the sprinkling method, and another one is known as the drip irrigation. So in this today's class, children, we have discussed about the three types of the or three steps of the preparing of three steps of the crop production. Among the three steps, we had the first step as a preparing the field, and next one is sowing the seeds, and third one is irrigation. Okay, in the irrigation we have again the two different and very famous advanced technology system, that is a drip irrigation, and another one is a sprinkling irrigation or sprinkling system. So in this class, before ending this class, I would like to give you a homework. You have to write what are the steps, whatever I have discussed in this class, what are the steps of the crop production. At least three steps you have to write, and if possible, explain those steps. Okay, I hope you will do this work. In the next video, we will discuss what is the drip irrigation, and exactly how it is done, and what is the sprinkling irrigation, and exactly how it is done. Okay.